Good afternoon, happy safe neighbour team. John speaking, how may I help? Surprised that you're not supposed to be on the pavement on this occasion. What's your name, fella?
It won't be used.
It won't be used against you. Not on this occasion, it's words of advice. If I was going to give you a ticket, I'd tell you I'm giving you a ticket. Okay? What I'm doing is I'm giving you words of advice now.
Well, I'll listen to you.
If I see you tomorrow...
Well, you know me.
I know your description.
No, you know me, so you need to take my name.
No, I'm sorry, we have to do it like this. It's an arrestable offence if you don't give your details when asked. You've committed an offence of cycling on a pavement. What happens if you come around the corner and you hit someone? And you've got no insurance?
No, I mean, I drive very carefully and very slowly.
It doesn't matter, we stop everybody that cycles on a pavement.
And you issue tickets or what?
Are you going to show me your identification or not?
I think you're going to misuse it somehow.
Okay, well,
I mean, you know me, I know you.
Okay,
know,
well, I stop
you gave me.
I stop 500 people a day. Mm-hmm. I'll get someone else to get it for me then, yeah?
Okay. Am I under arrest right now?
Not yet, no.
So I have to.
You will be if you.
Am I free to go?
No.
Well,
Victor Whiskey 7153.
7153, yes.
Thank you. Have you got a unit that's passing? No, Junction Palmerston Road. I've got a male detained. It's only for failing to give details, cycling on the pavement, but he's been a bit stroppy. It would have been worth the advice, but he thinks he can just do what he likes.
Well, this guy also on pavement.
Pushing it.
Ah.
He's
pushing it.
Yeah, it's about 2-4. Oh, 2-4, thank you.
I've asked you three times for your details. What am I going to do?
I mean, you gave me. Next time, you just arrest me straight away if you see me, right?
I stop about 500 people a day. Okay. I'm not going to recognise everybody, am I?
Are you going through all this list of 500 people? I doubt.
I think
you're going to misuse it somehow.
Okay.
I think I'm going to give you details, and you got to issue me a ticket. That's what I think.
Okay. I'm going to misuse your details. Yeah. Is that what you're saying?
Well, you said. You gave me caution, I accepted maybe, yeah,
and
okay,
I said I'd be giving you words of advice, but I need to take down your details, so if I was to stop you again, and you say, I didn't know, I'm not allowed to be cycling on the pavement, I say, well, hang about, I remember you from last week, your name is, no excuses. Why would I want to abuse your
okay,
name?
Okay, if you promise to not to use it.
In case of promising, I've asked you three times. I've now got someone.
I've now asked someone else
to come down who's going to get the details for me. It wasn't necessary, was it? I'm sure you're aware of words of advice and what that means. We're obliged by law to be honest. Not to take your details and then do what we like with them.
Then why do you need my ID?
Because it might be wrong what you're saying it is.
Hello there, gentlemen.
Hiya.
How are you both? All right. Hello, yeah. Sir.
Hi.
Hello, all right. So what's happened, Zanny?
No, nothing. Stops him cycling on the pavement. Uh-huh. Five times I've asked for his details. It's words of advice only.
Yeah,
well,
sure.
Why do you need them then? You're not having them. I said, well, it's proof that they're not. If I see you again tomorrow or next week, he thinks I'm going to misuse his details, so he won't give them to me.
I see, rightio. Okay. So I'd like to speak to this gentleman alone, very
quietly.
That's all right. So, okay, so do you understand, obviously? Thank you very much. What's your name? Just your first name?
Eugene.
Eugene, okay. Hello, I'm Ollie Clow. I'm a police constable from Mitcham.
Yeah,
obviously, you need to understand, firstly, this PCSO here, he's obviously got every right to give you a ticket. And a fixed penalty notice for £30 for cycling on the footway. It is an offence under the Highway Act, all right, mate? Okay, now this officer, he wants to deal with it by means of words of advice. So he wants to quickly just obviously warn you that it's an offence, and he quickly wants to take some take your name and details, and basically he wants to do a quick name check on you against the PNC, Police National Computer, to make sure you're not wanted or you
that's
anything
right,
like
yeah.
that. Once he's satisfied with his checks, that's the end of the matter. You don't get a criminal record or anything like that, okay? That's it. His details, your details stay in his pocketbook. That is the end of the matter. However, I do need to warn you that if he's seen the offence taking place, and if he wants to give you a ticket, okay, then you are obliged to give him your details. Okay, if you do not give him the details, the only option you
But I don't understand if he wants to issue ticket or not. Why, if he gives me advice, well, I accept that next time he sees me, just straight away arrest him, that's not a problem, right?
We know almost
I don't understand this, yeah.
Okay, I think all the officer's doing is just being very prudent, and he just wants to make sure that you're not wanted or anything like that. There's no other more serious offences that we need to worry about here.
So suddenly this bicycle became more bigger problem.
Sometimes it does. You obviously, he deals with what he sees, but...
But you know, I don't have ID with me.
That's okay, well...
So what are you going to do next?
Well, what we're going to do, this gentleman's going to quickly take your details, okay, and he's going to do a quick name check, make sure there's no...
But I can give any name I want, any date of birth. I don't have ID, physically.
Okay, well, if you
don't... So he can give you correct details, or...
Yeah.
But I can give...
We'll have a political debate about whether they give correct details or not. We'll just give you details, and then we're going to be on our way.
So it's okay to give me to give him any details?
Have a discussion about it. Just give you details. He's going to do it.
Any details is okay,
no,
right?
Your details.
No. Your correct details, sir. Give your correct details over, and then that's the end of the matter, isn't it? Situation resolved.
No.
That's... I thought there's more to it because he wouldn't give the details.
No, of course. No, thank you. I mean, it's that simple, sir. All this gentleman wants to do is take your details to do a quick name check. That's literally it. Give your correct details. Does a name check. As long as everything's fine with the check, that's the end of the matter. No criminal record, no fine. No,
it's just against my beliefs. I'm sorry.
It's against your beliefs.
No, I just don't
that's
believe.
That's absolute nonsense, isn't it?
I don't believe in
it. Okay, so by cycling on the footway, technically under the Highways Act, you have committed an offence and you are obliged to give your details.
Okay?
Yeah? Do you understand that? When you commit an offence in this country, you are obliged to give the police, in this case, this PCSO.
I don't know how much. I have no obligation to do anything.
Yes, you do.
Yes, you do.
No.
You do because you committed an offence, sir.
Okay, read my rights then.
Sorry?
Read my rights. When I'm under arrest, I have the right to
I'm not arresting you at this point in time.
So there is no point. There is no. Issue then. Am I free to go?
No.
Am I arrested?
Well, you're being detained at the moment.
Okay, so...
We're trying to resolve this situation amicably, sir. Okay, we don't really want to arrest you because, to be honest, we've got other better jobs to do. There's more important things to do. Police resources are stretched at the moment. That's why we're trying to do it here. This gentleman, he's just trying to give you advice, so don't cycle on the footway, which is an offence under the Highway Act. And he just wants to quickly take your details to make sure that there's nothing else we need to worry about. Okay? He's
completely
by law entitled to do that. The Police Reform Act 2002 gives him the right and the power to ask for your any details.
That's very fine.
Okay?
But I'm not obliged to do anything. I mean, there is nothing you can do. You can arrest.
You don't have your powers card on you by any chance.
Yeah. I mean, okay, I really don't like this. Okay, he said me, I give you caution or advice. Okay, I'm fine. I don't want this repeat anymore. I have my business. I have to go actually. So there's no problem. We talked nicely.
No, we're talking nicely, but obviously we need your cooperation here, sir. That's what's most important.
I fully cooperated.
I didn't drive away on my bicycle.
You can cooperate by giving your details.
No, I didn't want.
This isn't a game, is it?
No, I'm not playing with you.
Well, don't play and give your details, sir.
No.
Yes.
No. How? How are you going to extract from me details if I don't want?
You tell them to us. And then we write them down.
One of them should have a one.
It's quite terrorism. Simple, really.
That's the ethnicity one, isn't it?
You have something for me?
What is it? This gentleman is just trying to find a card that basically lists his powers under the Police Reform Act. And on it, it will say a nice bold writing. It will say that once you commit an offence, a relevant offence, I think it will describe it as, one of which is cycling on the footway, this gentleman has the power to ask for your details, sir. If you don't give your details...
Certainly has. As any human being, he has...
Yeah, there we go.
He has the right to ask me what
that is. And it's going to be somewhere, isn't it? I don't know. It's going to be somewhere, London. There you go. You see the issue of a fixed penalty notice, EPN, for cycling on the footway. It's just there, sir.
How much is penalty?
It's £30, sir.
Oh, that's okay. The issue of fixed penalty and penalty notice for cycling on the footway, causing harassment along the street, throwing fireworks, power to confiscate alcohol.
Did you get a clear view of it?
Okay, this is for you, right?
Clear view, yeah.
Fantastic, yeah.
Said it was been... You need to hand that back to the officer, so you can't keep that. That's
his. Okay. That's why I said it was words of advice only.
I mean, this officer's been perfectly reasonable with you, sir. I would strongly advise you, just give him your details, that's the end of the matter.
Let's have a deal. Next time if you see me on footpath, you know me.
Earlier, I said it doesn't work like that.
No. You arrest me straight away. This,
I can't do that.
Next time in court, you say this. First time I warned him.
These guys. I said I stopped 20, 30 people. I don't want someone saying to me 2 days later, I didn't know, I'm not allowed to. Because I can turn around and say, well, actually, I stopped you the other day, your name is.
Yeah.
So it's down to the officer, not down to me.
Actually, can I give any detail I want?
No, you give your details, sir.
But
okay.
If I give wrong details, incorrect details, what is legal consequences for that? Any idea? Maybe you had experience.
Can we start having this ridiculous discussion and just give your name? And
but I'm not enjoying. I'm not enjoying this either. I'm pretty sure you have better things to do.
So that's why we're trying to speed things up. Otherwise, the gentleman will just issue you a ticket, sir.
How? Without details?
It's well, that's possible. Why you need to give your correct details, isn't it?
It's that's the idea, but I don't want to give details.
Okay.
Well, which? So if you arrest me, that's fine, but you have to say this. I have a right to remain silent,
I will remain silent. I know what the question is.
So it's a. This some kind of
why would you want to get arrested over this matter? Don't you think this is a
because
waste of time?
No, I want to go. Can I go? I have
No, we're not letting you go until we resolve this issue. But don't you think, this is what's going to happen, right? If you don't give your details, okay, or you don't give your correct details, we have grounds to believe you don't give your correct details, an offence has been committed, no matter how minor it is, and that's the only option, plausible option we have is then to arrest you. Which, to be honest, is absolutely ridiculous. Okay, this gentleman's been perfectly reasonable with you. He's simply asking for your correct name and address so he can do a correct name check.
Well, he certainly has this right to ask me, but I don't want to talk to him.
Sorry?
I don't want to.
You can give me your details.
Well, if you want to be a in this country, then you have to abide by its rules and laws.
That's very fine, I understand.
Okay. If you don't want to give the gentleman your details, you can give me your details. I don't care.
No, thank you. Just call me Eugene, that's my name.
Your name is Eugene, fine.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
And what's your name, Eugene?
No need for that.
Well, yes, there is, because we're asking you. I don't think you decide whether there's a need or not, we decide.
But
what's your surname?
But what are you going to do next? I mean, I'm not telling you anything.
Sorry?
I'm not telling you anything. In fact, I can request an interpreter.
We're having a discussion in English.
But I don't think there's any need for interpreter. You've demonstrated that you have a perfect understanding of the English language here, Eugene, so I don't think there's any need for that.
If you want to escalate this, I have to... So I can express myself much deeply.
You can have one at the police station.
Okay. Well, arrest me.
Sorry?
Arrest me. For what?
Fine,
for
failing to give you
an arrestable offence, yes. If you fail to give yes. details.
If you've committed an offence, Eugene, which we've already explained by cycling on the footpath under the Highways Act, you have technically, though it's a minor offence, you usually deal with it by a fixed penalty notice, or in this case, words of advice. Okay, we're kind of going around in circles here. Okay, you've technically committed an offence by cycling on the footway. The officer has seen you do it, he's tried to advise you. Okay, and he simply wants the details.
I have to stand firmly on
that. Usually how we deal with it is by a disposable option, by handing you a £30 fixed penalty notice, which is a £30 fine. Okay, but
to do that, we
need your correct details.
That's what I thought.
Yeah?
He wants to issue a ticket.
Yeah, exactly that. He wants to issue
a
ticket.
We'll just take him to some custody.
If you refuse to give details, then the only choice we have is to arrest you.
Okay, let's go.
Right, come on then.
You're under arrest if you fail to give details after committing offence.
Yeah,
it doesn't have to do anything, but it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questions don't reach your later line.
Would you put it in my pocket, please?
45,
please.
Okay. My bicycle. Go ahead. Last
49 seconds. We actually can fold it on the
pool. No, we can't.
If you take it there. Thank you.
Sorry, guys.
No, it wasn't.
We're putting it to take a statement of some kind.
It's safe. Take your bag off, please, Eugene. Thank you very much. I've still got your wallet, by the way. Thank you very much. Just going to get it there for a second.
Lane check on the stop, please. Keep the way. I'm bleating on the right now.
I'm doing horrible.
Marvellous. Thank you.
If you can repeat the name
of the road, I'll stop.
Eugene, there's nothing I need to worry about in this bag, is there? Okay. I'll tell you what, let me rephrase that question. There's nothing sharp that would harm myself. No? Okay. I need to warn you that if during this search, if I hurt myself, like a needle or a sharp object, you are... Wait, no, it is your fault. Yes, it is. And technically more, you can be arrested for assault, okay?
to your phone. Your phone's in the bag, okay?
I do it.
Yeah, you see? You see? Yeah, can't have it in your purse if you so wish.
Facial
hair, dark brown, and other products. Let me just check the face.
Oh, we don't have a face. Yeah, so you do a
So basically, if I'm clean, you will let me go, isn't it? Issue a ticket and let me go, right?
If we can confirm,
well, we decide, though.
If we can confirm your details, there's a possibility that you'll be de-arrested, and we can deal with this matter by a fixed penalty notice, which is a ticket. Okay,
that's up to.
Okay.
Sorry.
Got any of the green ones?
Green ones. Yes. Isn't it an FPN?
Oh, you mean the.
Yeah, it's a non-endorsable, yeah, it isn't.
Oh yeah,
I've got it. Yeah, I should. Unless, have you got an FPM for the thing?
No, I one up this earlier, but
no worries. I should have some.
As long as I've got his details, I'm happy that if I bump into him again, then obviously
yes.
I can give you the ticket on
it's
the second occasion.
It's completely
up to you. Now Eugene is under arrest, you can have his details.
Discretion with yourself.
Yeah, it's are you ready? It's fine.
What's the date of birth?
23/10/18.
And where was he born?
Sorry? Where was Estonia.
Okay. So, I mean, what do you reckon, guys? I mean, it did say originally it was going to be words of advice.
Well, he doesn't want to accept that, does he? So he's going to have to.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, the officer's it's going to be the officer's ticket because I haven't seen the offence ever. So it's completely up to you, but I would strongly advise give the gentleman a ticket because he's being fairly uncooperative, to say the least.
Yeah, okay, that's fine. That's fine.
Yeah. Okay, Eugene, what's happening? We all confirmed with name and address and everything like that, yeah?
Well, it's a business address. It's a business address. The address on your driving license.
Business? Why business?
This, the like Worth Street. What address is this?
What information they gave you?
No. What
do you say business? What,
well, they told me it's a business address.
How do they know? No.
Sorry?
They said it business.
But it sounds as if it's a business address.
Oh, okay.
I mean, no one really lives at number one or number two, universal house. They usually live at one or two, don't they? And 88 to 94. Well, what is it? 88? Is it 94? Is it?
You have no idea what you're talking about, really.
That's why I'm asking you. Yeah. But you're not going to tell me.
I can't. I'm still under arrest. I can't talk too much.
What do you mean you can't talk too much?
But I'm under arrest.
Right.
This nice gentleman told me very specifically that.
Well, so you think when people are arrested,
it's going to be used against me, isn't it? So I have to.
No, not at all, Eugene. What we're trying to confirm, sir, is where you live. Because what's going to happen is you're going to be issued a £30 fine. However, if we're not happy with your address that you give us, we can't issue this ticket. That means we have to take you back to the
I gave you nothing,
but
actually.
Listen, it means we need to take you back to this police station, and then fingerprint you, etc., etc. That's and why we're trying to do it like
we've
this.
He's already been arrested.
Yeah.
Which is not surprising, really, is it? given your attitude. Which is unfortunate.
Yeah.
I know you want to record us.
Yeah.
This is a £30 fine, right? If you've got 28 days in which to pay it or request a court hearing. So you must do one of those two things.
Mm-hmm, okay.
If you do neither of them, it'll be registered as an unpaid fine and a warrant will be issued for your arrest.
Oh yeah, no.
Warrant and then I get arrested and next morning I get to see judge. I get to see judge.
You're probably going to say, yeah, potentially, that could be a case, yeah. You would have to, you'd be taken.
You could have your license.
And there, sir? You'd be taken to a magistrate's court and you'd explain to the magistrate why you haven't paid it.
Oh, okay.
And then they make a decision.
But then you
there.
Could avoid that by requesting the court hearing in the first instance. If you are one to contest it.
Thank you. So it's a fixed £30, never gets higher.
Hmm?
This penalty never gets higher.
Well, it does if you
second
don't pay.
Second offence, tenth offence, third. So I pay £30 each time.
No, they're always £30.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Every time you issue a ticket, it will be £30.
Okay.
I'm sure that wouldn't be necessary, though.
Well, worth a shot. They say worth a shot.
Right, all the details are on there, where you need to send it to, and how many days to send it in. Otherwise it goes up, I believe it's the third, isn't it? Third after.
And then it goes up by 50%.
£15.
So it goes up to £45 if you don't do anything with it within 28 days.
15, that's
it goes up to £45.
That's top. That's top.
It goes to £45 if you don't do anything with it within 28 days.
Okay.
If you still don't do anything with it, the court will issue a warrant for your arrest.
Oh,
and
okay.
They'll take you, you'll go to a magistrate and you can explain to them why you haven't done anything with it. Which, if you can't give a good reason, they'll probably charge you even more. Okay? Simple as that.
Probably, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Have you got any tattoos on you?
No comment.
Sorry?
No comment. Actually, it's quite dangerous to cycle on the road.
Indeed,
I'm pretty scared of buses.
I would recommend
smashing.
Getting a cycling helmet, a high visibility jacket.
Won't help against the bus. How many did? You probably know. How many did people? How many cyclists? Lots of them.
Unfortunately, so, sir. No, that's very true.
Because it's a stupid traffic act.
Mm-hmm. I mean, very much so. I would just recommend, obviously, I'm a cyclist myself, cycle very safely, always be aware.
Yes. Are you cycling along the road?
I do, I never cycle on the pavement, firstly because it's a nuisance, and secondly, I think it's too slow anyway. I've got a nice bike, I like to stay on the roads where I can go fast. Especially in an area like this, you see, Eugene, it's a busy area,
I'm more conservative.
People walking around, you can't cycle on the pavement here.
Oh, come on, you don't believe in it.
I never cycle on the
Never
pavement.
Once.
I never do.
You don't believe in this.
I've got a road bike, it gets damaged if I cycle on the pavement. I have to cycle on the road.
I've got double suspension, I can handle anything.
No, you've got a bit of bike on
it. You need a bit of WD-40 on it, though. It's a bit rusty. Chain's a bit rusty.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, Eugene, that's your copy, sir? Has he signed it?
I'm not going to sign anything. Fine. I'm just...
Yeah?
I just if you want...
Then put signature with you. Yeah, I'm going to sign it.
Signature
is there's refused. You don't want to sign it? Signature's refused.
Okay.
Okay, do you understand your options of how to deal with it, Eugene? Yeah? Fantastic.
Yeah, 28.
In that case, you're de-arrested. Okay, you're free to go.
What's the time now?
14:51 hours, okay,
14.
By my
okay.
Watch.
Okay.
Okay, lovely.
I'll see you.
Well,
I knew I'll forget
Fantastic.
Something.
Right.
Okay, see you.
Please, cycle
see
in the road,
In if future.
Yes. If you're on the pavement and you don't want to cycle in the road, that's fine. Please walk your bike on the pavement, alright? Certainly on a busy pavement such as this. Okay?
Okay.
Right, Fantastic, thank you very much.
See you, bye. I mean, this doesn't it's no, doesn't sound right. Are you sure? There's no trouble for you or for me?
I didn't fill the ticket incorrectly, to be honest, anyway. And rather than do another one, it'd be unfair to keep you here. So,
no, I'm fine. I just I want to protect myself and I mean, nice gesture, but you kept your word.
It's not a gesture. It's just I've cocked up on the ticket, and I'm not prepared to write another one out again. Okay.
So there is no legal consequences for me.
There is no legal. There's no legal requirement for you to pay the ticket. Not now or later on. It's all there. I wouldn't submit it after you've gone. Unless you want me to write one out for you again and redo it.
No, I mean I'm not. I'm a poor man.
No, it's all there anyway.
Actually, well, if you're sure, well, thank you.
Right.
Thanks very much.
Just going to throw it in the bin anyway.
I'm going to...
As long as you're happy, but I would advise you in future that next time you are stopped, don't miss someone around like that, because you could end up getting yourself arrested.
I mean, that's fine. If I believe in something, I stick to it. I try to stick to it.
Yeah, but it's going to cost you every time then, isn't it?
I've got all the time in the world. I'm a free man.
Okay, well,
but if you're sure everything's fine, okay then, thanks.